Lord, I thirst for you. Make sure your children come.
Yes.
Make sure your neighbors, anyone that you know that is a youth, let them come. And the Lord God Almighty is going to release His fire
Amen.
Upon our youths in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. By the grace of God, we have come to pray again today. And the Lord God Almighty is set for us. Are you set for the Lord?
Yes.
How is your race?
I am running.
We'll keep on running our race until we see our Redeemer.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Before we begin to get the meal to pray today, we want to share a song from Psalm 27.
Hallelujah.
The song says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?"
Amen.
There is fear all over the place. Yes. People are afraid of what is not even there.
Yes.
So the Lord God Almighty gave us an assurance in Psalm 27 that as long as He is our light,
yes,
we're not walking in darkness,
Jesus,
then we have nothing to be afraid of. No darkness, nothing is qualified to put us in the bondage of fear.
Mm-hmm.
For He has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind. Say, I have a sound mind.
I have a sound mind.
Say, no more darkness in my life.
No more darkness in my life.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So you can open to Psalm 27 and sing along with us from verse 1. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? Whom shall shall I fear?
The Lord is the strength. The Lord is the strength of my life. Who
the world did not create me, the world cannot take me. The Lord is the strength of my life. Who shall I fear? Father, thank you. Lift your voice and declare that the Lord is the strength of your life. Father, strengthen me here, Lord. Let there be, O Lord, a renouncement of your power. Thank you, precious Redeemer. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Our daddy God, we bow before you, Lord. You are the light. You are our light, our salvation. You are our all in all. Without you, we are impotent. It is in you who live and move and have our being. Father, we worship you. Thank you for gathering us again on this global altar. The altar of revelation. The altar of strength. The altar of light. The altar of truth. The altar that, Lord, you raised to gather your children, Lord, to prepare us for where we are going to. Daddy God, we are grateful. We ask that, Lord, you continue to take the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we ask, Lord, that you will search our hearts and examine us, Lord. In any way that there may be sin in our lives, knowingly or unknowingly, Lord, we repent, O Lord, at your feet, Lord. We add your blood, O Lord, we cleanse us from every sin of unrighteousness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We ask that, Lord God Almighty, Lord, you will take over our lives, O Lord, today on this global altar. Feed us, O Lord, till we want you more. We'll never be tired, O Lord, of your feeding, Lord. Let your name be glorified, life of your son over there. Your daughter is there. There's a family over there, Lord, that are looking upon you. The minister that is there, that you ordained, Lord, is there. Let there be, Lord, a revival today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, our sweet daddy, God. Take over my life, Lord. Sit on me, Lord. Let no man see me. Let everyone see you. Let only your name be exalted. Thank you, our sweet daddy, God. You are the best of the best of the best. We love you, we love you, we love you, we love you, Jesus. On behalf of everyone on the global altar, Lord, we say we love you, Lord. Glory be to your holy name. And if the rapture should take place while we are here, Father, please count all of us, O Lord, worthy on the global altar, and our family members, O Lord, to be caught up with you in the air. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, sweet dad. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Let our family over there say amen.
Amen.
Wow, what a wonderful day.
Hallelujah.
It has been a glorious season. And I want to thank God that we are alive and well.
Hallelujah.
By the grace of God, the Lord God Almighty has called us because the Lord has revelations to give to us today.
Amen.
The Lord has a message for us.
Amen.
The Lord wants us to start by telling us that He can bring out the most beautiful things from evil things.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Even for COVID-19, how will I know you?
Hey, la, la, la.
COVID-19 is evil, physically speaking, it's killing people. Mm. But the Lord said inside COVID-19, Makosu Katalibra Kasuka Lalagalante, inside COVID-19, I've brought out beautiful things.
Hallelujah.
In fact, I must confess a little bit about that the past 7 months, in this year are the best months of my life.
Hallelujah.
The past 7 months are the best months.
Yes.
That if rapture should take place within the 7 months, I'm sure by the special grace of God, because I've never been more focused in my life. So I thank God that God can turn evil to good. Go to the book of Jeremiah 52. Jeremiah chapter 52 from 31. 34.
Jeremiah chapter 52.
Yes, sir.
I read from verse 31.
Yes.
And it came to pass in the 7th and 30th year of the captivity of
Jehoiakim. And it came to pass in the 37th year of the captivity of a child of God, Jehoiakim, the king of Judah. Yes.
In the 12th month.
The end of the year.
In the 5th and 20th day of the month.
Yes.
That evil Merodach king.
Somebody say evil Merodach. His name does not sound righteous. But look at what the Lord did with evil Merodach. Yes.
King of Babylon. In the first
year. A hidden nation. A godless nation. Yes.
In the first year of his reign.
Lifted
up the head of Jehoiakim.
Somebody say lifted up.
Lifted up.
Other people have been coming. Other kings have been there. They didn't see a child of God. Right. But God brought someone that has evil with his name. His name started with capital letter E.
Evil.
God used him to do a lifting. The Lord God Almighty said, every negative thing you seem to be going through, he's going to turn it around.
Amen.
To lift up your head.
Amen.
So you will see his glory.
Amen.
Because he said, I am the God that created light, I created darkness. God Almighty created darkness for a purpose.
Yes.
If you do not see darkness, you will not appreciate light. And that is what God is telling us that he did in the life of Jehoiakim. Read on.
Lifted up the head of Jehoiakim, king of Judah.
Yes.
And brought him forth
out of prison. How can evil bring out such a deliverance? God Almighty is saying that even through this COVID-19,
yes,
through all the troubles you are going through, he is going to bring you out of every prison of your life.
Amen.
Be it a prison of a pastor, or of a church, or of a job, whatever is the prison of your life, God Almighty will pass through what you have been going through,
yes,
to bring you out.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Yes, 32.
And speak kindly unto him.
You will begin to hear good words, because there is nothing like good words in prison. Nothing nice is in prison. Prison is a place of violence. It's a place of sorrow. It's a place of regret. I don't even know that they even have time to take their bath. The prison is not a place for anybody to go to. I have been to prison ministry. And I know how it is. Even though that I'm a minister, maybe I'm not able to endure the stench in the prison. I don't know about abroad. I'm talking about Nigerian prison. God Almighty said he began to speak kindly to him to change his mindset. He has been used to violence. Some of us, you entered into marriage. Meanwhile, you were having issues in your home. You saw your father beating your mother. It made your mind to be blocked towards sweetness in marriage. And you're not yet healed, and you got married. And you have carried over what you were passing through in your father's house into your marriage. The Lord is saying today, he's speaking kind words to you.
Amen.
He's speaking love to you.
Amen.
He's speaking healing to you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord said, we start today by renewing the mind of my children that evil can turn to good.
Amen.
The Bible says, he began to speak kind words to him.
And set his throne above the throne of the kings.
Those who have been kings, who have been out of prison, when he came out of his prison, the Lord God Almighty made sure that he didn't lose anything.
Mm-hmm.
Promoted him above all those that were free, seemingly free,
that's
before
right.
him.
Amen.
When the Lord turns around the captivity of Zion, the Bible says, we are like them that dream. It looks as if, oh, am I dreaming? The Lord said, that is when your mouth will be filled with laughter.
Amen.
The Lord God Almighty is saying to us today that there is something he's going to do in this global altar.
Amen.
He's going to do something on this global altar.
Amen.
Yes.
And change his prison garments.
So change his prison garments. When the Lord God Almighty is giving deliverance, all your garments will change.
Yes,
that's, I don't know why a child of God will say you're a child of God and you are not changing your prison garments. You still dress like a prostitute. You have not removed your dress. The Bible says when blood Bartimaeus was shouting and calling upon Jesus, he said, how, son of David, have mercy upon me. The Bible says when they called him, the first thing he removed was his garment. He threw away the garment of blindness. Because God said, today I am going to open the eyes of my children.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You cannot wear the same garment you wore while you were in bondage.
No way.
It has to change.
Yes,
like I don't care how beautiful it is physically. God Almighty said there are prison garments. When you are in sin, you are in prison. Like a label, when you are committing sin, you are in prison. Like a label, so when you come and unrighteousness. Your garment must change. Don't mind the pastor who are deceiving you. That God looks at the heart. God looks at the heart, but He changes your garment.
Yes.
Yes, come on, sir.
And he did continually eat bread before
him. Somebody say continually.
Continually.
When God changes your garment, this is about you, Bakuli and Alagayah. You are not removed the garment, so that's why you cannot receive the beat of God. Until garment change, you cannot change location. You'll be sitting on the floor. When your garment change, you cannot sit on table. Because the table of the Lord is not a table of dirty and prison garments. He's the King of Kings. The Bible said that we are chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood. God Almighty says, and he did. Somebody say continually.
Continually.
That is why you cannot hear the word of God once in a while.
No.
You cannot do prayer work monthly. There's nothing like annual prayer work.
No.
Or monthly prayer work. Or quarterly. Prayer work is a daily work.
Yes, yes.
God is the God of daily.
Yes,
say, this is the day the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Keep us this day our daily. He's a daily God. He's a daily God. He said, I did eat bread continually. Yes?
Before him.
Somebody said before him.
Before him.
All the days
of his life.
When God Almighty brings you out of prison, it's not going to be temporary. It is continuous. Because as you are eating the word of God, you are getting stronger.
Yes,
you are getting wiser.
Yes,
you are becoming like God with a small G. Yes. One in the Bible says in 34.
As for his diet,
yes,
there was a continual diet given him of the king.
I want to ask you, what is your spiritual diet? Diet of chicken and rice. What is your spiritual diet? What are you eating? What do you eat spiritually? It matters what you eat spiritually. The Bible says, and for his diet, there was a continual diet
given him of the king of Babylon.
Yes?
Every day a portion unto the
Somebody say every day.
Every day.
Child of God, you need daily portion of spiritual diets. God Almighty says he wants to feed us daily.
Amen.
It's a prayer rain. It's a word feast. God Almighty says, I am preparing table for you spiritually. No longer will you be hungry. The food will be ready waiting for you. God has no time to worry about physical food because that one is fixed.
Yes.
That is his duty as a father.
Yes.
So don't bother about what you're going to eat or drink or put on. It is my duty as your daddy.
Yes.
The food here is the food of the King of Kings.
Yes.
He said continually.
Every day a portion.
Every day a portion.
So the day of his death.
What suits you?
Right.
The daily bread is what suits you for that day.
Yes.
What you use and carry for the evil of that day. Bible says sufficient is the evil of every day.
Yes. Yes.
Every day has its own temptation.
Yes.
God will give you a daily bread, a portion that will carry you every day of your life. Until when?
All the days of his life.
All the days of your life. All the days of my life. There will be no breakage. It will be bumper to bumper. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So why don't you lift your hand and say, Father, thank you for whatever I'm passing through.
Father, thank you.
Call whatever I'm passing through. Thank you. Lift your hand and say, Father, thank you for COVID-19. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
When COVID-19 started, I remember the Lord, when I was saying, Lord, what's going on? The Lord said, tell me thank you. It sounded very strange.
Yes.
What should I tell the Lord? Thank you for COVID-19. But as I began to tell him thank you, I began to see the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
God began to use COVID-19 to even reveal false brethren.
Yes.
He revealed many things. COVID-19 is a gift to my mom. Even for COVID-19, I'll still be eating with enemies. Not only that, these are killers. COVID-19 is a gift. Everything you're passing through is a gift.
Thank you,
for if you did not have that toothache, you will not give thanks to God when the tooth is working well. Even the fever is a gift. For if the fever was not there, you will never appreciate when you sweated. Everything you're passing through is a gift from God. As I say, in everything, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus
concerning you.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Lord God Almighty said, today, the meal for today for us to eat, and then begin to receive the grace to pray. The Lord is saying, today, he said, receive your sight. The Lord said, the most important gift anybody can have is their sight. Apostle Paul used years to be praying for the church in Ephesus for them to have sight. Open the book of Ephesians chapter number 1. Ephesians chapter number 1. Like a libra kosunta, like a libra kosunta, like a yay, yay, Holy Ghost. Like a libra kosunta, like 17 and 18, sir.
Ephesians chapter 1. I read from verse 17 and 18.
Yes, sir.
That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Go to 16, start 16. Look at 16.
Cease not to give thanks for you.
I cease not to give thanks for you.
Making mention of you in my prayers.
Making mention of you in my prayers.
That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Father of glory.
Father of glory.
May give unto you the spirit of
may
wisdom.
May give unto you prosperity.
The spirit of wisdom.
God Almighty is giving us insight to understand priority. Value system. Not what they have made us to feel makes us to be Christians.
Right.
The Lord said, if you want to be a child of God, you must have the spirit of wisdom, yes?
And revelation.
And revelation in the knowledge of Him, of Christ, yes?
The eyes of your understanding.
Is it a full stop?
No.
It's a continuation.
Yes.
It's a colon. That means it is not yet complete.
Yes.
What is verse 18?
The eyes of your understanding.
The eyes, you may have physical eyes and yet you don't understand anything.
That's right.
The word of God cannot be read with our physical eyes.
No.
There's an inner eye.
Hallelujah.
There's an inner eye to the word of God that people may not see.
Yes.
But the Lord will open your eyes to see it.
Amen.
It is called scales. We talked about it in the last podcast.
Yes.
Scales, you don't drop. Say, when you begin to say, oh, I see. Your eyes are opening.
Hallelujah.
Many people, their eyes are blinded in the churches. They don't see anything.
All
they are seeing is what they have believed and they have been taught and they have something that this is what they're going to believe. And so they are walking under the spell of what they have been told. They have never seen anything. They see men as trees. Until when you hear the word of God, you say, wow, ooh, yeah, I see. You are beginning to get enlightened.
Amen.
That the eyes of your understanding be enlightened. Say, Lord, I receive enlightenment today.
Lord, I receive enlightenment today.
Grant my eyes to have understanding.
Grant my eyes to have understanding.
Of who you are.
Of who you are.
And your word.
And your word.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That is why you do not go into the word of God without prayer.
Yes.
Apostle Paul said, I don't cease to pray about it. Cease means I don't stop. It's a bumper to bumper.
Yes.
I will not rest until I see that you have understanding.
Amen.
You will no longer be fighting the word.
Yes.
You will no longer be arguing with the word.
Amen.
You will receive the word with meekness.
Yes.
Mix it with faith. Yes. Let it begin to walk in your life. That's when I know that the word has entered.
Yes.
That the eyes of your understanding
be enlightened.
Yes.
That ye may know what
is in your eyes are enlightened for you to understand God's way, you pursue the world. You will be carnal. All your prayer will be prayer of physical prosperity. Hey, Kalaboko Sunta Lagalanta.
That ye may know what is the hope of his calling.
That ye may know what is the hope
of his calling.
Why God has called us? He called us unto holiness.
Hallelujah.
He called us as peculiar people.
Yes.
Say, you dwell alone.
Yes,
you don't mingle with the world.
Yes,
he said, come off my mountain and be separate.
Yes,
hey, Kalaba, you cannot do like others. There's a garment I put on you. Others don't have that garment. It is a beautiful garment.
Yes,
he said, you must be different.
Yes,
so that you know that there is a hope of your calling.
Yes.
When you hear calling, it means you are with a crowd.
Yes,
calling means you are with others. And then they now called you.
Wow.
And when you are called, people notice you.
Yes,
and they'll be looking and say, will she come back?
No,
God called you out of darkness.
Amen.
Thus in the dark, they will not see you again.
Yes.
Them of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Don't allow the Lord God Almighty to be disappointed.
Yes,
because he's seen that people that you are with and you have left, they are expecting you back.
Mm.
They have given you the dates to return. They have betted on you. They betted on you. They say, is it not her? Is it not Cheryl? We know Cheryl. She is going to come back.
No way.
We know she will miss the club. She's going to miss the club. She's going to miss fashion. This one that she's removing her jewelry. What kind of jewelry is this? She's going to put it on. They are giving you dates when you are going to give up.
No way.
I will not give up my faith.
I
will not get blind again.
In
the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because you can get blind again.
Ah,
I'll see people that would see, they got blind again. God Almighty says, when your eyes are enlightened, you become valuable spiritually.
Amen.
Your priorities change. You no longer pursue mundane things.
Yes,
the things of the world don't excite you. You cannot protest. Look, no genuine child of God joined protest.
Yes, sir.
Anyone who has gotten this hope of this calling cannot join protest.
Yes,
for they know that they are seeking for a king.
There's
a blessed hope. They are not of this world. They may be here, not of this world. People of the world can do as they like, but we do not join. That is why it's an abomination for a pastor, a child of God, to support the world to go and die. Where did it lead to today? We are going to cry to the Lord because the youths are going to be on fire for God. The youths are going to, the Lord will be scratching their throats for prayer. There will be a hunger in the low youths. The youth will say, Jesus, we need you. The youth will be mad for the Lord. They will be mad for Jesus Christ. And then they will behold the hope of his calling, yes.
And what the riches of the glory of
his... And what the riches of his bank account.
Riches of his glory.
What kind of richness is God talking about here?
Riches of the glory.
Riches of his glory in...
Of his inheritance.
Of his inheritance in the saints. God is after heaven. That is why your eyes open. If your eyes do not open, you will never see the glory.
Yes, sir.
You will never appreciate what we are going to. Hey, all the things they are passing through, you will be seeing them as if God hates you. You will know that the sufferings of this world, according to the book of Romans 8:18, that the sufferings of this world are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed. There is a glory in Romans 8:18. There is a glory. Hey, when we get to heaven, and the marriage supper, all the saints shall gather, and the last assembly, no more sad parting, no more breaking, farewell to sorrow, victory ahead. People of the world. God will restore our youths. God will comfort our youths. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible said there is a riches of glory of his inheritance.
In the saints.
When, please read verse 19. Somebody read verse 19.
Verse 19.
Yes.
And what is the exceeding greatness?
What is the exceeding greatness of his power?
To us what?
To us what?
Who believe?
Do you believe?
Yes,
I believe.
I believe.
And God said that there is an exceeding greatness of his power.
Hallelujah.
That will work in my life.
Hallelujah.
According to
the
working
of his mighty power.
I will
power.
Operate on the same realm with God.
Amen.
Hey, Kalaboko Sonia. The power of sight cannot be emphasized.
Yes, sir.
God said, receive your sight.
Amen.
Say, I receive my sight.
I receive my sight.
If there's any prayer you must pray, child of God, is to come out of spiritual blindness.
Yes, sir.
When you come out of spiritual blindness, when you see people, you know that people that are blind, they think that they are seeing.
Yes.
They think they are seeing. And you be beating them and giving them arms. Do you know that are blind, that are blind people that are very proud?
Yes.
So blind people are going to hell, to go to hell as well.
Yes.
That you are blind doesn't mean you will go to heaven. Uh-huh. There's nothing like pity party there. There's no blind in heaven.
Yes.
We shall be changed.
Yes,
so anyone that is blind over there, you're a child of God. If you don't see in this world, you will see the face of Jesus. You will see his face at last. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm not moved by what is happening in this world. Because there's a big gulf between heaven and this place. I am not of this place. Are you of this place?
No.
Are you looking for somewhere?
Yes.
And I we shall get there.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Go to the book of Luke chapter 18. Luke 18. Luke chapter 18. Yes, sir.
Verse 1.
Read from verse 41, my son.
Luke chapter 18, verse 41
to 43.
Saying,
yes.
What will thou that I shall do unto thee?
This is a story about a blind man. Because of time, we can't read all of them. But it's not about a blind man.
That's right.
And came to Jesus. Yes.
What will thou that I shall do unto thee?
And Jesus asked you today, what should I do for you?
And he said, Lord.
If the Lord should give you an option to tell him what you want him to do for you, what would be first on your list? Is it to have Jeep? What will be first on your list? A question is posed to you today. When you are writing list of prayer points to Jesus, what is number one? I don't know about you, but I know my number one. And my number one has nothing to do with physical prosperity. Nothing to do with having car, having land, traveling abroad. It is not even first ten. The first ten, there's no money there. Because I have understanding. My value system has changed. My mind has changed. I know that everything in this world is dunk. It shall be melted down. I don't need to even pray for things of the world. Because there are people who don't pray and they get them. I ask for things of eternal value. Things that money cannot buy. Hey, Kalaboko Sundala, that's what I desire from God. Ah, Kalaboko Sundala. Unfortunately, preachers have made us. Our eyes, our attention are all on things of this world. Materialism everywhere. God is going to trash that preaching. That message of rich, getting rich and prosperity, God will deal with it on the back. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Read on, my son.
And he said, Lord.
What did he say?
That I may receive my son.
He said, Lord, that I may receive my son. Somebody say specific.
Specific. Hallelujah.
He knew that if only he can see again, he will not wear color riot dressing. He will not eat whatever they present on the table. He cannot eat what he wants to eat. Rakalepo kosunda. He can walk into where he wants to walk into. Rakalepo kosunda. That I may receive my sight. So that when people are eyeing me, I will see their eyes. I don't want to be a fool laughing with my enemies. Let me receive my sight so I can walk, I can serve you, I can read my Bible. That I know of a blind person who reads Bible.
Yes.
They can't read any other book. They don't see anything. Yeah. But when they open Bible, they can see it. Yes. They see Bible. I was not about an illiterate. He cannot speak good English. But once he is preaching, it's Queen's English. Once he finishes preaching, he goes back into speaking all the manner of upside down English. He's not straight. God Almighty is strong.
Yes,
sir. Our Redeemer is strong. And I may receive my sight. One more time, the Lord said, receive your sight.
Yes,
that is when there was no time. Jesus did not waste time to answer that prayer. He said, this man understands what he wants.
That's right. And Jesus said unto him. Receive thy sight.
Receive thy sight.
Thy faith has saved thee.
Thy faith has saved thee.
Immediately,
there is faith on this global altar. The Lord said, as this person land is coming, as this world is coming, your faith is coming up. Bible says faith coming by hearing and hearing the word of God. Whenever you hear the word of God, not the word of man, not my papa said, my mama said, while reading the word of God, as the word is coming, you may not feel good pimples. We're not here for good people's spirituality. We are here for spiritual mindedness.
Yes,
good people can feed, yes, but your mind cannot feed. Like a nipo kosunta la galanta ya. The Bible says,
and immediately.
When you pray spiritual prayers, there is no delay.
That's right.
God can delay job. He can delay marriage.
Yes,
he can delay children.
Yes,
he can delay all those things.
Yes,
but he cannot delay this spiritual prayer point.
That's right.
For you to see.
Yes,
he said what? And immediately he receives his sight. Did Jesus touch him?
No.
Did he turn him around?
No.
Did he push him?
No.
Did he pour holy fire?
No.
He just said unto him.
Did you hit him mantles?
No.
Did he donate money?
No.
Did he bring a seed?
No.
Every wicked preacher saying until you sow seed before you can get your miracle, God will expose all of them.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You do not need to sow any seed,
yes,
before
sir,
you get your miracle.
Yes,
it is a preaching that came from the queen of the coast,
uh-huh,
called Jezebel.
Yes.
Like, I should be debunked here.
Hey.
Like, the Bible says immediately he received
his sight and followed him.
No, I went to do party.
And followed
him. You know, some of you, when God gives you miracle, you go and throw a party.
That's right.
You go and begin to celebrate and buy new clothes. When God gives you sight, when you see God, you will follow him.
That's right.
You cannot follow the preacher.
That's right.
You will follow Jesus. Say, I will follow Jesus.
I will follow Jesus.
I will follow my Jesus.
I will follow my Jesus.
Is the one that opened my eyes.
Open my eyes.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He followed Jesus.
Glorifying
and he began to worship God.
Amen.
When you have received sight, you will know God.
Yes, sir.
Apostle Paul said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection and the fellowship of his sufferings. When you know God, you go deep with him. Nobody can take you out of Jesus. You cannot backslide because of somebody. Nobody can discourage you out of God. Hey, Kalabokosunda. All this because of what they did to me in church, I couldn't stay again. I had to go. You didn't meet Jesus. When you meet Jesus, he's too sweet. You cannot jump in. Hey, Kalaboko. Who can you compare him to? Incomparable Jesus. Unchallengeable Jesus. Hey, Kalabo. Irreplaceable Jesus. Hey, Kalabokosunda. How can you drop Jesus? For who? The Bible says he began to worship God. He said, hey, so there's God there. Eh? Oh, there's Jesus. He began to worship God.
And all the people, when they saw it,
when people saw it,
gave praise unto God.
No, they sowed seed.
Gave praise unto God.
They began to go to church.
Gave praise unto God.
It's not church adverts. It's all about Jesus. We don't drag people to church. We drag them to Jesus. When men see Jesus, they will not go out, they will not backslide. They will know the church to attend. Some of you attended church because you're looking for miracle. You attended church because you're looking for husband. And they say that church is full. And you counted, the big church like this. That means I'm going to have at least up to 1,000 men. And you feel that you can catch at least one out of the 1,000 men. You saw so many cars in front of the church. I say, there'll be a connection of business. They will give me a job. Oh, you heard that the pastor of the church is a billionaire. He does annual, monthly distribution of money, and you want to join the church so that at least they will give you some money. Rabo Kosunda, you need to consider your diet. What am I going to eat in that church? It is what you are eating that will open your heart. It is called vitamin alpha. What are you eating? That is why you're not getting your sight. You're getting blinder and blinder. You will see white, you call it black, because there is blindness. One thing I declare to us, only remember us, blindness is going. Receive your sight in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's why you need the right guide. Anybody say that nobody can talk to me, nobody can. God said somebody will tell you what to do.
Yes.
I will guide you, the people that will tell you what to do.
Amen.
Open to Acts 9:6, Jeremiah 3:15. Acts 9:6, Jeremiah 3:15. Because God said today, this is a season of eye-opening.
Amen.
Somebody say eye-opening.
Eye-opening.
We are in the season of eye-opening. Hakuni and Alagale from Kosotaya. Open to those two passages. Acts 9:6.
Acts chapter 9, I read verse 6.
Yes, sir.
And he trembling and astonished said,
yes,
Lord.
The Bible says when Jesus encountered Saul,
yes,
he didn't call his name. Mm-hmm. He just said, Lord. Because what? You cannot meet Jesus and mistake him.
Oh.
He doesn't, it's not a man. When you meet Jesus, you know that he is Lord.
Yes,
Lord. When you meet the Lord, you don't request for bread. You don't request for money. When you meet Lord, you say, what can I do, sir?
What would I have me to do?
Many Christians did not meet Jesus.
Yes, sir.
What can I do for you, sir? They went with their sin. They went with their fornication. They went with their immorality. Their lying. Their bitterness. I said, give me miracle. And the pastor, without asking about your life, began to pray for miracle. A true child of God, when you encounter God, what comes out of your mouth? What can I do, Lord, for you? You bow to him and say, what can I do? Read on.
And the Lord said,
what did the Lord say?
Arise.
Arise.
And go into the city.
Enter the city.
And it shall be told you what.
Someone said, it shall be told you.
It shall be told you.
He didn't say, I will tell you. He said, I'm going to prepare somebody there that will tell you something. It shall be told you. If you are proud, you cannot receive from God.
Yes.
It had to take a housemaid to deliver Captain Naaman from leprosy. From a housemaid to his servant. He listened to ordinary people, all you big men of God, rich people, that you cannot sit down to even listen to your driver, who knows God. That is why you are not healed. That is why your spiritual life is down. Because God can send errand through anybody. The Bible says, when you enter the city, there is somebody that will tell you something. Did you call the person's name?
It shall be told you.
You are not meant to choose who will talk to you.
That's right.
God said, I will tell you who will talk to you.
Right.
Like a neighbor, I will connect you. Like this global altar, and God connected some of you here.
Yes.
Some of you look as if you have known each other for a long time. Like my daughter, Diana Helen, even my daughter, Diana. Some of you look as if you have known each other for years. What is making us so close is Jesus that we met.
Yeah.
Is this truth?
Yes.
He's the one that introduced us together. He said, meet this. Hey, can I? There's power in introduction.
Yes.
I remember when I took my late husband before we got married to go and introduce to my mother. I remember when I said, mommy, meet my fiance, Williams, meet my mommy. And I was smiling the two sides. Hallelujah! Hey, Kalaboko Sunda. Very soon somebody over there will to introduce. Yes, shall be an introduction. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am blessed to know you. I love you so much. You are a wonderful prayer partner. Thank you, my Father. The Bible says it shall be told you what you will do.
Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15.
Yes, sir.
And I will give you pastors according
to
my heart.
The Lord said, I am the one that will give you pastor.
Hallelujah.
According to my heart.
Who shall feed you with knowledge?
Somebody say, feed.
Feed.
The pastor I want to give to you will feed you according
you,
to
Jesus.
My will.
That's right.
Yes.
With knowledge and understanding.
With knowledge and understanding of how to serve me, not how to make money. Not how to go and rule in politics. Hey, child of God. Who is pushing you into politics? Is it God that sent them to tell you? Don't you know that when God sent sense and errors. He makes it easy for you. Rakalipo kunja nagalataya. Did you hear one day that Apostle Paul was sick? Rakalipo kusuda. Did you go and visit him in the hospital? You know, Apostle Paul, from when he said yes, Lord, to when it was time for him to go, he asked for death. Apostle Paul is on a sign signature. Say, I want to now die. I have finished my course. I have done all my work. I am now ready to be offered. No sickness one day. No immoral story one day. No long story of his life. When God calls you, he equips you. You will not allow you to go and suffer corruption. The Lord Almighty is calling us today. It is time for us to hear from him. Let him tell us who will give us instruction. In the mighty name of Jesus. God said, I know my children. I know my people. All over the world, I am gathering them. I can bring them from the north, the south, the east, and bring them to the center. That is who God is. And God Almighty said, all the preachers teaching you how to make money, like a lepo kosundala, they are not sent by me. Luke chapter 18, 17 to 25. Luke 18, 17 to 25.
Luke chapter 18, 17 to 25.
Yes, sir.
Verily I say unto you,
verily I say unto you,
whosoever shall receive the kingdom of God as a little child,
yes,
shall in no wise enter therein.
Yes.
And a certain ruler asked him, saying, good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?
And a certain who?
And a certain ruler.
A big man, a rich man.
That's yes. Right.
Uh-huh.
Asked him, saying, good master.
Good master.
What shall I do to inherit eternal life?
Rich people are looking for eternal life.
Yes, sir.
But they don't know that there's a test to pass. But the preachers give them more vibes. They give them more spirit of covetousness. Rich people, if they are given the seed of wealth of eternal life, they will know how to take decisions.
Yes.
But when they want eternal life, they are going through things in their house. You don't know what they passed before they get to church on Sunday morning. You give them front row. You even stop message. You are preaching, sir. You stop and say, I want to welcome one of our daddies. And, you recognize them during the preaching of the Lord. You tell the Lord, you put him on pause. You put God on pause. To recognize a politician. You are expecting a political man to come to the church. And he's delaying his coming. And when he comes, he sends his protocol. He sends his bodyguards to go and screen your church. Without their machine to detect bomb. Like that, they feel that you have put bomb inside the church. Like they don't fear God. They come and check the chair that you put for their boss. And you are there saying, oh, it's okay. You are there betting them. You are disgracing God. God said it is time for him to enter the churches and dethrone every seat they have reserved for killers. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He can for eternal life. If only you had told him when he came to tell him, sir, that your second wife must go. I said, sir, that your cap on your head removed it. Honor God. You cannot kneel down on a rock here. Take your rock home and come and kneel down on this floor. Before the King of Kings. And God's kingdom is not the kingdom to rule over kings of the earth. King of Kings means King of Kings. You and I are the other kings. God is not the king of the kings of this world. The kings of this world, all of them are worshiping idols. Before I finish this scripture, the Lord said, go to Psalm 96. Read Psalm 95. All the kingdoms of this world, they worship the devil. Rakalipo kusunda. It is the king of King Nkechi. There's no queen. There's no queen, none of the spirit. There's no queen. God has no queen. He's the king of kings. Rakalipo
kusunda. For all the gods of the nations are idols.
Psalm 96, verse 5.
For all the gods of the nations are idols.
Some gods.
All the gods.
All the gods of
nations.
God said every nation, every kingdom.
kingdom.
What happened to them?
Are idols.
They are worshiping idols.
That's right.
God cannot be king over idol worshippers.
That's right.
America has idols. UK has idols. All the nations, Nigeria, Kenya, name them. All of them have idols that are worshiping. That's why when you go to any country, you don't go there and relax. For every nation has a peculiar idol. That's why when you go to some nations, you don't know when you begin to become gay. You didn't plan to be gay, but there's a demon in that nation controlling them. That's why I get so pissed off with Christians who mention Scotland to me. Do you know the idol in Scotland? Who is ruling in Scotland? How can Scotland be used to replace the scripture? To dress like a woman when you are a man. To wear skirt. And the pastors in Scotland, they wear skirts. They wear skirt to join people. It says their culture. The cultures of this world, they worship idols. Go back to this Luke chapter 18, my son.
Luke chapter 19, verse 19. And Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me
good? Why are you calling me good? Because I'm all a hypocrite.
That's right.
And they call Jesus good. But when they go deep, somebody say deep. If we can go deep into some Christians, you will see their real nature.
Uh-huh.
You go deep and begin to take a mount pressure. It is in the place of pressure that we know the real Christians.
Yes.
Consistency in righteousness is not easy. That's why the Bible says the book of Luke chapter 1, verse 74 and 75. Holy Ghost, I give you glory. Luke 1, 74, 75. Before you go back to this scripture, Holy Ghost is here. Luke chapter 1, 74, 75.
Luke chapter 1, 74, 75.
What does he say?
That he would grant unto us. That we've been delivered out of the hand of our enemies.
Might serve Jesus Christ without fear.
In holiness and righteousness.
How many times?
Before him all the days of our life.
Holiness and righteousness is a continuous process.
Yes,
it's not once in a while. It's consistency. When you are consistent in holiness, then you can be called a holy child of God. You can be called a saint. It's not today you are Christian, you are living holy, tomorrow you change your mind. That's a backslider. Go back to Luke 18. Holy Ghost, I give you praise.
No is good, save one.
Jesus said nobody is good.
That's right.
Yes.
That is God.
So how can you say that this? How can you say this Jesus is God?
Huh?
This Jesus is Mary's baby.
Uh-huh.
We must know how to separate Jesus. For when he was man, like when he told Mary in the wedding, he said, "Woman, my time has not come."
Yes.
That was not her son.
Yes.
That's why he lost gold him. You know, I can't talk to your brother like that. She quickly coiled away and went and told the servants, "Whatever he, not whatever my son says, like a leper person, whatever he tells you to do, do it." Hey, Kalaboka, for she knew it has separated.
Yes.
This is not my son that I breastfed. This is God talking. We must not differentiate. The person talking here is saying, "I am not good." You cannot claim goodness. The man of Calvary said, "I am not good." No one is good except God. God Almighty said, "Take it that I am one God." This is a flesh that I used. I begot him. God Almighty says, "This, yes, save God, save one, yes, God."
That is God.
Yes, that is God.
Thou knowest the commandments.
You know the commandments.
Do not commit adultery.
Do not
kill.
Do not steal.
Do not bear false
witness.
Honor thy father and
thy mother. Mother is summary.
And he said, "All these have I kept from my
rich youth." Rich men always feel as if they have it all.
Yes.
All these gospel singers that are popular, they have money. Before you preach, they say, "I know my relationship with God."
Yes.
I pray.
Yeah.
I fast.
Yeah.
I give. They have CV of their holiness.
Yes.
But they have not been searched. Who was they
searched?
If all those thieves who go to steal knew that there was CCTV camera, that's why they went to put it off in Nigeria.
Yes.
If thieves know that there is CCTV camera, all all over the shop. They will not do shoplifting. They will not steal. Akalababata has a pick and they hide. They don't see anybody. But when they get to the gates, they will know that police is waiting there. There is a God that searches. He has his own CCTV camera. He's the one that created us. Do you know that in very sophisticated shops, there are some clothes that they put alarm that looks like a toy?
Yes.
It looks like a toy, a rubber thing, just fits on the dresser. If you think you have 10 heads, go and carry it out of the gate without paying. The alarm will ring and you'll be arrested. But it looks like a rubber toy. Do you know the kind of rubber toy God puts? To catch. To bring out the real you. Hey, Kalipo, go to Kandalaya. The Lord is saying to you and I today, He's searching us. All your personal CV of holiness, God is going to put them down.
Yeah.
I tell you that we are not yet ready.
Yes.
Thank you.
He said what? Oh, somebody say all.
Oh.
He gave himself 10-10.
That's right.
He gave himself eight stars.
All these have I kept from my
He said, all these.
Have I kept?
I have been a Christian from childbirth.
That's right.
That's what I feel from a Christian family, not in a Christian family.
Yes. Yes. Thank
when
you.
We are entering that city, it's name by name.
Yes.
Not by family.
Yes.
Yeah, my great grandfather built church in our village. Nobody's going to consider that one. God is saying to somebody today, it is time to take stock of your personal life.
Amen.
All these things I have kept from my youth up.
Verse 22. Now when Jesus heard these things,
when Jesus listened to him and heard him,
he said unto him,
he said to him,
yet like as thou
somebody say,
thing.
Somebody say one thing.
One thing.
You can give yourself 10-10, but every good teacher gives an extra mark.
Thank you, sir.
It is called extra.
Yes.
That is what the five wise virgins had. Like they had someone say extra oil.
Extra oil.
The others are virgins, but they didn't have extra. Yeah. He said, Kitty, why are you covering your neck? I said, I'm doing extra.
Extra.
Like a lepo kosunda. Why are you covering your head? I'm doing extra.
Extra.
Like a lepo kosunda. Why are you not feeling free? I'm doing extra.
Extra.
I am not free because my hand is on the cross.
Yeah.
My leg on the cross. Everywhere is pierced. I am no longer myself.
Yes.
I cannot feel free.
Yes.
You can feel free, but I cannot feel free.
Yes.
Others may, but I cannot.
That is it.
One thing remains. Just one thing you lack.
Yes.
And that one thing can cost you everything.
That's right.
For God is a God of 10 over 10 mm-hmm. of His standard.
Yes.
You see, you lack one thing. We don't
sell all that thou hast.
Sell everything you have.
And distribute unto the poor.
Go and give the rich people.
Unto the poor.
Sell to the dumb for them to buy AC.
The poor.
That's the recommendation of Jesus is that money should be given to the poor.
Yes.
The rich should not be given money.
Yes.
You cannot do birthday for your pastor.
Yes.
You cannot do billboards and be celebrating pastor's birthday.
Yes.
That billboard you are using to do birthday.
Yes.
Even you can put Jesus as Lord.
Yes.
Souls will be saved.
Yes.
Not exhibiting men in the name of doing birthday. That is vanity upon vanity.
Yes.
That is wastage of divine resources.
Yes.
And you will be judge.
Yes, sir.
You pastor that is accepting that billboard, putting your picture there to do your birthday, you shall be judged by God.
Yes.
God is going to ask you, am I the one that permitted you to use that money like that?
Uh-huh.
Did you know that even Judas Iscariot, I was the one sending a message to go and buy food?
Yes.
Even a thief took permission before he went to buy food. You that you are supposed to be accountable for my money, you ask my children to celebrate your birthday on billboards all over the town. Hey, Kalaboko Sunda Lakalantaya. The Lord God Almighty is going to deliver. He will deliver His innocent children in the mighty name of Jesus. He will open their eyes. He will remove blindness from them in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says,
and thou shalt have treasure in heaven.
If you want to have treasure in heaven, Jesus told this man,
sell all that thou hast.
Do without them. Count them as dung. God knows that he has spent years. He has spent time. His importance is in his money. Until you drop what makes you important, you have no treasure in heaven. Your treasure in heaven is measured based on how you count these things as nothing. That somebody that you can feed can even insult you,
yes,
and you will not retaliate.
Yes.
That is how you know.
Yes.
That you can reply text message of ordinary people.
Yes.
When people send me text message, by the grace of God, I give God all the glory. I don't know if there's anybody that sent me message that didn't reply you. The Lord told me, Keji, one of the major tests, I am testing my children who I use, who I give things, is that I will send ordinary people to give them message, to even call them on phone. If they do not answer or reply, it is a sign that they are proud. It is pride for somebody to send you message, you do not reply. Unless the person is abusing you. Even when they are abusing you, what do you say? God bless you. The Lord told me it is a major test. I test people to see. Some of you, they will even send you message. You will even reply without greeting. God told me, catch it. Greet everybody. Greet even small people. Greet them.
Sir.
Don't mind. I'm the one checking. I am the one with the marking scheme.
Yes.
Like a lepo kosunda. Greet them. Like a lepo kosunda.
Yes.
The Lord told me, don't abbreviate. When you are writing people, don't abbreviate.
Yes.
You know some people that they feel too big to type thanks. THANKS. They will type it TX. They are too busy. Like, because it's pride. Like, Kurianda, like a lepo kosunda. Like a lepo. You have not seen my daddy God. Pride is in IJN.
Uh-huh.
When you type IJN, you are proud. Like a name, because you can never write, you can never abbreviate your name on a check. Like a name, because when you want to write check for you to go and cash money, like a name, you don't abbreviate. If your name is Blessing Paul, you don't write BP. Like a name, because you write your full name. Why? You know that there are other BPs. Your Blessing Paul is different. God said that your sense, I have it. That your I created you. I said I created you. You don't have sense. It is time to repent and come out of your pride. Everything you have, you are giving. Finish up the scripture, someone.
Yes, daddy.
And thou shalt have treasure in heaven.
Have treasure in heaven.
And come follow me.
The Lord said, rich people, you are rich in your gift. You are rich in money. You are rich in houses. You are rich in things. Nigerians that are rich, some of their buildings and cars have been burnt down by angry youths.
Yes, sir.
All what they labored for years came down in less than 1 hour. All their efforts in vain, going down the drain. This world is empty. This world is nothing. I have Jesus, I have everything now. Oh, I have decided to follow Jesus. Distractions of the world. Are you saying that we should not have money? No, but don't pursue it. Don't pursue money. Stop hustling. Serve God. He will direct you on how to make money. As you give him glory, that will not soil your garment. He said, come and follow me.
And when he heard this,
yes,
he was very sorrowful.
Rich men don't want to give up their money. They love their wealth. He was very sorrowful.
True.
It is hard for a gospel singer to go to a function and go and sit down and watch others.
Yes. No.
They want to climb there and compete with others and showcase their gift. Until as a gospel singer, you go to a program and you sit down without touching a microphone,
yes,
and you are happy throughout, you are not qualified for Jesus.
Thank you, Dad.
Or as a gospel singer, you are there to minister without collecting a dime from them, you are not yet ready for Jesus. The Bible says, for he was
very rich.
When you are very rich in knowledge, in wisdom, in money, when you are rich of the things of this world, in position, in status, you get sorrowful if God wants to touch it. There's sorrow that comes. That sorrow is an evil sorrow.
Yes,
it's not a godly sorrow that needs no repentance. Finish up, sir.
And when Jesus saw that he was very sorrowful,
He said,
How hardly shall they that have riches
enter
into the kingdom of God?
God said it is hard for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Pastor say everybody should be rich. So the pastor is saying that the whole church should go to hellfire.
For it is easier for a camel.
The Bible says it is hard. Jesus is the one that said it.
Yes.
How hard? It was an exclamation. How hard shall it be for the rich to enter the kingdom of God? Look at it. Is that exclamation or full stop? So an exclamation mark in my Bible.
Yes.
So what's the exclamation mark? The Lord told me, can you take note of all the commands? For every command has power.
Yes.
Exclamation mark has power. Don't tell me now, take note of it. Is it the full stop?
No,
I have to check. It's an exclamation.
Right.
He exclaimed. He wailed. He cried. Because he see the pastors are preaching to the people that they should look for money. And he is giving us a danger sign. He's giving us people. Don't clap. Don't look for. Don't covet riches. For it will make you to have big head. It will give you sorrowful heart. All those gold you are buying, if Amabas touch it, you will have an attack. Invest in the treasure of God. Invest in heaven. Live a life of a pilgrim. Don't backload. For your Lord has no space in this kingdom. Reduce your load.
Yes,
Bible calls it weight.
Yes,
your weights are the thing that beset you.
Yes,
all your load you're carrying. As I am lazy, can't you see where I can jump? I don't have any earring to enter my car. Can't you see where I'm jumping? My handkerchief is still white. I can use this handkerchief for 1 week. But if I go and put my cane, after 30 minutes, it is content. Live a simple life for Jesus Christ. Is it finished, son?
No.
Finish up the scripture.
For it is easier for a camel. So go through the needle's eye.
Look at. Look, I don't try to put thread inside needle.
Yes.
Like me now that I'm 51 years, our eye is wonderful in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord said, camel can pass through. Before each man can enter heaven, camel and thread, which one is bigger? Thread takes me up to 20 minutes to put. I have to look, and the more I look, the more I put it to pass this. It's no more enter the road. The Lord said, rich man cannot enter heaven till camel has passed. Hey, what and the church said that you should continue to search for money. The whole church is filled with network. Hey, Kanabokosuga. Every pastor's wife, their boots are filled with goods from Turkey, from Dubai. They will even know all the countries. Say, this one is from US. This is US back. This is Turkey back. This is Dubai back. They have the country attached to it back. Akuni and Nagala. And then when you wanted to give an offering, you consider that you have something to buy, you reduce your offering. Rakulia, don't meet up. Laposuntalaga, Librakantalaga. And all their showbiz, all the uniforms of the church, they're telling you that we're going to buy this. We're all going to wear blue lace. And you do not have blue lace. You only have white lace. They say nobody will come here without blue lace. You go and trouble your husband. That is what is going on. That God Almighty said, enough is enough.
Yeah.
Get back your sight.
Amen.
That's blindness.
Yes.
You are passing under the yoke of blindness.
Yeah.
The Bible says it is better, easier for a camel to go through a needle's eye than for a rich man to enter into the kingdom of God. God Almighty says He wants us to serve him in simplicity and modesty. Not pursuing money. Beware of pastors that push you to go and make money. Beware of pastors that make money to look as if money is everything. That always preach to you and tell you that the lender is always a slave how do they call it? That the borrower is a slave to the lender. They use scripture to push you into covetousness. They say that if you don't have money, you're not important. They say that this car you're driving, nobody will go to respect you. You need a bigger jeep. They begin to organize programs in the church that only the rich can afford because they attach money to that program. And then the poor ones will be struggling to get that money just to attend that program. As if Jesus is the one that is there. Jesus is everywhere. Oh, Jesus is everywhere. Oh, Jesus, he really cares. Oh, no matter what you're going through, he'll fix it just for you. You can see them to pray for you. That preacher is serving Jezebel.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
God Almighty said Jezebel must be exposed.
Amen.
She's a gangster. She likes to form gangs. The one that carried men to go and protest. That's a fellowship in Nigeria. The leader of the fellowship carried the women in a fellowship to go and protest in Nigeria. When the Bible said that the women should be wailing, be in the house in sackcloth and ashes. Anna was in the temple crying. Women should be inside crying to God. It took 5 women to cry indoors in Scotland. And God began to want revival. God will raise godly women.
Amen.
That we stay inside and call upon God.
Amen.
And we will not rest until there's a revival.
Amen.
In the nations, in the name of Jesus. So, Revelation chapter 17, we are rounding up. Revelation chapter 17, read from verse 1.
Revelation chapter 17, I read from verse 1.
Yes.
And there came one of the 7 angels,
yes,
which had the 7 vials,
yes,
and talked with me, saying unto me,
yes,
come hither.
Come hither.
And I will show unto thee the judgment of the great hall that seated upon many waters.
The great hall! The prostitutes in the churches.
That's right.
Yes.
With whom the kings of the earth has committed.
Somebody the kings of the earth.
Kings of the earth.
All rich people must be careful of this hall. Because if the hall does not come in the shape that you know, anything that you have that people are looking for, popularity, you have fame, you have money, you have wealth, you are a king in your own right, this hall must come after you.
And the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with her wine.
She must come after you with her pride.
That's right.
She must come after you to give you class. She will come with big girls club in name of women fellowship. Come with big boys club, philanthropist club. This hall has the fine shape she uses to enter big people. Especially in the area of pride. It starts with pride. It starts with who you think you are. Once pride comes into you because you have something, this hall will come after you. Read on, son.
And the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication.
Yes.
So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness.
Read on, my son.
And I saw a woman.
I saw a woman.
Sit upon a scarlet colored beast.
Yes.
Full of names of blasphemy.
Uh-huh.
Having 7 heads.
Just keep on reading,
and
my son.
10 horns.
Yes.
And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color.
Yes.
And decked with gold.
Somebody say decked.
Decked.
When you find yourself wanting to project yourself all the time, sweetheart, child of God, that is Peter Jezebel.
Yes.
Jezebel likes to be projected.
Yes.
The Bible says as children of God, we should be dying daily.
Yes.
Christ should be formed in us. Not we anymore. It's no longer I that live, but Christ that lives in me. When you find yourself wanting to do something that will bring you out, that will showcase you, that make people begin to admire you, Spirit of Jezebel is at work.
Yes.
That hall is at work.
Hey.
Read on, sir.
And precious stones and pearls.
Yes.
Having a golden cup in her
hand. I want to ask you, how do you spend your money? What collects your money? What collects your attention? Because people worship what takes their attention. Whatever takes your attention will be your idol. You will worship it. Whatever gives you joy, you will worship it. I want to ask you, what gives you joy? Now, some people shopping gives them joy. When they look at the number of shoes, they have joy. Some people, it is sex that gives them joy. Some people, it is their bank account. They don't be looking at it and taking all their balances. And when it is dropping, they want to get more money to fill up. They don't want, they have put a particular mark that their money must not reduce. It gives them joy when they see that their money is $20 million. They smile and feel good and show every other person. What gives you joy? Your ministry is not going to afford to give you joy. The only person that should give you joy is Jesus Christ. That is where our joy is. Husband should not give you joy. If husband was giving joy, that means I would have been a useless woman by now. Because for 15 years I have been without a husband physically. Sex cannot give me joy. That means I would have died by now. Children cannot give you joy. If children gave you joy, why do you guys say if you give this child, you will kill yours? Children don't give joy. If you put Jesus as the source of your joy, he will make you to enjoy all the benefits. You do not fix your joy on somebody or on something. It is idolatry. You are worshiping an idol. And Jezebel will come on you. You have become his, a member of her family. Because she's a gangster that gathers family members. Like to perpetrate even in the church, in the families, in the nations. Read on. Some.
Having a golden cup in her hand.
Yes.
Full of abominations and filthiness.
Abominations and filthiness of her fornication. All of you that joke with fornication, I wish you know that fornication is a major problem in the realm of the spirit. Fornication is what makes God to kill people. Fornication is the height of worship of Satan. Fornication is the prison worship of the devil. When the devil wants to operate, he pushes people to commit fornication, either by physical or by phone. That you are not physically committing fornication, but in your phone, there are body parts. You talk trash in your phone. You use sexy languages in your phone. You are having sex. God Almighty says it is time for us. If Jesus tarries, God will deliver all the youths from fornication.
Amen.
Our youths will hate fornication.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Bible says, full of her fornication.
That's right.
And upon her forehead
was a name written.
Yes.
Mystery.
Babylon.
Babylon the Great.
Yes.
The mother of harlots.
What's the mother of harlots?
Mother of harlots.
I don't know how in my Bible is capital letters.
Yes, capital letters.
She has title.
The mother of harlots and abominations.
Mother of harlots
and abominations.
Not of harlots. These harlots, they are found in the church.
Yes.
Mother of other harlots. That means she's a mother harlot. Training other women harlots. Daughters. When you say they're very stubborn. When you watch the spirit of Jezebel, they are very stubborn. They will attack. If you just talk about their dressing, they will shout. If you say anything, they will attack you. Once you see anybody attacking because of dress, spirit of Jezebel is walking there. They are immoral. Because a true daughter of Zion is not going to be wild. Wildness is a sign of spirit of Jezebel. When they are wild, you see all these persons that are cursing on the pulpit, they are operating the spirit of Jezebel. Certain people with their tongues. Child of God, how can you be using the tongues of people to boost yourself? Where's your own tongues? All the preachers that are recording tongues and sending a souvenir. And the level kosunda la baya. And you use people's tongues as your ringtone on your phone. Like a level kosunda la ya. Like if I'm praying in tongues and I'm touching my soul. As I'm praying the Holy Ghost, I'm touching my spirit. I'm getting hot. I'm connecting with the Holy Ghost. And you go and record it and go and be playing it. That is idolatry.
Yes.
Any Christian that is playing the tongues of a preacher and using it to boast, that Christian is an idol worshiper, and the preacher is the person's ghost, not the Holy Ghost. It's preacher ghost. It's GO ghost. It's bishop ghost. The Bible says this mother of harlots
and and abominations.
Yes, that is her title.
Right.
All abominations, including protests that kill people.
Uh-huh.
I was shocked when somebody said that the protests in Nigeria that God ordained it to, that God will cleanse the land.
No,
I said, with blood of children.
No way.
You can see how wicked Christians are. God will cleanse the land with the blood of children. The Lord Almighty will purge the land of wickedness.
Yeah.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Do you not see why God said that daughters of Zion should not dress their children to be like prostitutes? Because he said that there will be evil and wickedness in the land. We have seen it with the mother of harlots. She is the supplier. Because some mothers, they may not pay school fees, but they will not lose the money to wear jewelry on their children. They will have money to do the hair of their children. But they cannot pay school fees. But that prostitution is not sponsored. You see some widows, I see some widows, they don't have food to eat, but they did their hair. And I say, you say don't have food. Ah, you get it. Somebody dashed me. As well, did they dash you hair, but they didn't dash you food. They dash you attachments. They dash you lipstick. They dash you jewelry, but they didn't dash you money to eat or how to do business. That would tell you that mother of harlots knows how to sponsor her wares. Rakale Bokoso, that she sponsors this materials. Read it verse 6.
Verse 6.
Yes.
And I saw the woman drunken
with the blood of saints. Why? Saints open door.
Yes.
When the church opens door and allow all the Jezebel preachers to come and seduce the people and beg them to bring money and make them to begin to come and lick his leg. They will have access to drink the blood of the saints.
Yes.
To drain their spiritual energy, to drain their holiness, to drain their fear of God. Hey, Father, deliver me from abominations of the mother of harlots. In the name of preachers, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord and Almighty said, it is time for your eyes to be open. Receive your sight. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, yes, go.
And with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And when I saw her,
I wonder with great
admiration.
The people of God are always carried away by the beauty of this mother of harlots. She's idolatrous. She sponsors worldliness. She sponsors all this covetousness. It's the work of mother of harlots. The work of Jezebel. Whenever you see churches who always do relationship talk, always talking about relationship, that is Jezebel in action. Talking about sex. Come, let's talk about sex. Let's talk about sex. When you hear talking about sex, you know that the devil has carried Jezebel's spirit there. Any church emphasizing on love, sex, relationship, they must come and prove to me the seminar God had for Adam and Eve. Until they show me the seminar of Adam and Eve of relationship talk, like how to have sex, then I will allow them to have that program in church. The church is to know about God, not about how to have sex. Having sex is natural. God is the one that teaches them on the bed. He honors couple who honor him on their wedding day. He begins to honor them. He teaches them how to have sex. Marriage is not about idea. When you begin to see people that are specialists in relationship talk, they are not clean. Jezebel has taken over. To initiate people into the sex world. There's a sex world. There's a sex world. Where you are drunk with the spirit of sex. You cannot pray. You always want to adorn yourself. You want to showcase your breasts. You are body. You love romantic films. Watch yourself after such talks. Your life doesn't remain the same.
Yes.
All the youth will be delivered on Sunday.
Amen.
If Jesus said in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because after such relationship talks, that's when they begin to fornicate.
Yeah.
After every relationship talk with teenagers, with youth, they fornicate. Because they have brought out what should be hidden.
Yes, sir.
Teenagers don't need relationship talk. Youths don't need relationship talk. What they need is how to fear God.
Yes, sir.
Ecclesiastes 12:1. Hey, Kalabokoso, Holy Ghost. Like a Babalandaya. Hey, Jezebel spirit, she loves power. She loves power. My sweet son. Jezebel spirit loves power. They love posts. Jezebel spirit, they love to have their own fellowship. Where they'll be organizing. God Almighty will expose Jezebel. in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because it's not going to be a one-day matter. On the number altar, the Holy Ghost will be revealing there. So your eyes will be open. See, so this is how I am. Just see, that spirit, they are very, very idolatrous. They love position. They love power. They love to exhibit themselves. They love to be sexy. They are seductive. They are gangsters. These are the qualities of Jezebel. They like to be as if they are the only one. They love awards. They want to be recognized. Listen to me, child of God. There is a cup that Jezebel carries. That abominable cup. God will break it on this altar. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We shall come out of that cup. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because many of us have drank it. I have drank it. But the Lord has delivered me. He is still delivering me. Every day as he's opening my eyes, saying, you see, you drank this. Like when you talk, there's some way you talk, God will say, you drank this. Somebody that you went to kiss, and the person kissed you with serpent tongue. And the person kissed you with serpent tongue, they transferred poison to you. Your dream changed. I'm talking to somebody over there. Your dream changed. You began to have sex in your dream. Everyone having sex in their dream. God Almighty says, but in the altar, you are going to be delivered. In the mighty name of Jesus. Good, let's get to read some for the youths.
Ecclesiastes chapter 2:1. Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth.
The Bible says, read it again.
Remember now thy creator.
Have relationship talks.
Remember now
thy creator. They are all aru, remember a relationship.
Yes.
Have relationship talk. Have love and talk about sex. What did God say shall happen?
Remember now thy creator.
The Lord said, take time.
That's right.
To remember the Lord.
In the days of thy youth.
When you still have your strength.
That's right.
One day, if you keep having sex as a youth, you will become weak. The more you are secreting, the more you are draining your emotion, the more you will be weak. You cannot do exploits. You cannot be on fire. God Almighty says, if Jesus tarries on Sunday, fire will be released from this global altar. Upon our youth, on our teenagers. In the mighty name of Jesus. Remember now, not when you are sick, not when you cannot move again. Remember now, thy creator, the one that created you,
that's
in
right.
The days of thy youth. Is it finished?
No.
Yes.
While the evil days come not.
Because evil days are coming.
That's right.
When you're not able to endure.
Mm-hmm.
But if you build up God now, you can say no when the devil comes. If this youth in Nigeria, if they had been serving God in strength, they would have been strong to know the will of God.
Yes.
That God cannot send them to go and protest and die.
Hey.
And now the protest came to naught. Nullified. And everybody's in their house. Like a lepokosunda lagayana. It's over. Lepokosunda. Hayakayana lagayana. Depend on Jesus. Child of God, depend on Jesus. Man will fail you. Depend on Jesus. Rakalabokosunda. Oh Jesus. We are depending on you. Oh Jesus.
Yes.
When trouble came, they left them. What a wicked world. Hey, Kalaboko Sundaya. If they had succeeded in their protest, they would have said, we are the one that made it happen. They would have come to take glory. Hey, Kalaboko Sundaya. What a wicked world. Hey, Brako Sundaya. The devil will not get our youth again. In the mighty name of Jesus, our youth will depend on Jesus. Our youth will call upon God. Our God will raise Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. God will raise Esther. God will raise Daniel. God will raise Joseph. God Almighty will raise Timothy. He will raise people that will stand as youths in this land. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All over the world, God will raise his youths. For the time has come.
Yes, sir.
We are going to pray, children of God. Today we are going to pray. God Almighty said he's about to do something. Please don't pray. Don't joke about Sunday. Gather your children. Gather the youths. Everybody on this global altar, Jesus tarries on Sunday. Let us call upon God. We are going to cry to God today for on this global altar. We are going to pray for President Donald Trump. And I was saying, President Donald Trump, God said there's a J in between his name. And that J is not his name. It is Jesus. He said, Donald Trump, I'm staying in the center. I don't care how Christians have been manipulated by Jezebel. God will turn their minds back. They'll be losing from the hand of Jezebel. To reason like God. To think about God. It's all about God, not about any man. God Almighty said it is time to come out playing. We're not in the court. We are going to openly come out and declare that we stand.
Yes.
Like we stand with God. Raboko Sundalakaya. Open your eyes, children of God in America. All the Christians in America, let your sight be opened. Let your eyes be opened. Receive your sight today.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lift your hands and say, Father,
thank
you for your word.
Thank you,
lift your hands and begin to call upon God. Father, thank you. Thank you for your word today, Lord. I receive your word with meekness. Lift your voice and give him God praise. Give him glory. Give him glory. I appreciate God for the word. Give God glory. Give me praise. The word of God is clear. The word of God is clear. Oh Lord, I give you glory for your daily bread. I thank you for the provision for today. The provision of God suits me today. I thank you, my Father. Thank you, precious Redeemer. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
I'm going to pray and say, Father,
Father,
I am sorry, Lord.
I am sorry, Lord.
When I complained about what I was passing through,
I never gave you thanks.
I thought you were punishing me.
I thought you hated me.
Don't bring out goodness in my life. I can have peace the rest of my life. Open your mouth and begin to ask God for mercy. Daddy God, I'm sorry, Lord. I murmured, I complained. I didn't see. I was blind, I couldn't see, Lord. Hey, Kalaboko Sundalakaya. I repent of God of murmuring. I repent of complaining. I repent I didn't know. I even reported it to people. And they deceive me. They make me don't feel as if I am not praying enough. And I have not sold enough. I don't give money enough. Hey, my Kalaboshandaya. Lord, I am sorry, Lord. Have mercy on me, Lord. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we are praying. Lift up and say, Father,
thank you.
Call that situation. Whatever you are passing through, call it. Say, Father, thank you that in this sickness, whatever it is, give God thanks. Whatever you are all over the world, there is something you're going to thank God for. Thank Him. I know it looks foolish. You sound crazy. Thanking God for no job. You sound crazy. Thanking God for no husband. You sound crazy. Thanking God that you do not have child. Lift your voice and thank Him. It looks as if you are a fool. But the Lord Almighty said, I have a plan. I am the one that created darkness. I can bring a lifting from evil. Ah, kalabosota lagaya. Hey, kalalabosota ya. Hey, nolokosota lagaya. Lord, I thank you. 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 Oh, nagalabokosota lagaya. Oh, we are saying thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. We are saying thank you, Jesus. Lift your voice and thank you.
Thank you, my Lord.
Oh, we are saying thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, my Lord.
We are saying
thank you, Jesus.
Terrible thing to be blind. Physical blindness is already a problem. Don't let your spiritual blindness. You are going to cry to God and say, Father, deliver me from blindness. I receive my sight today. Clap your hand and cry to God. Clap your hand and cry to God. I receive my spiritual sight.
With a blind man.
out. I come out for worshiping me. I come out. Church, you can leave a church because maybe they anoint you and you walked away. You can also leave a church to preserve your faith in God. Not that you are backsliding, you are preserving your faith. Only to take people are going to talk, but the talk will not last long. If you can endure what people are going to say, you will have your total freedom. Jesus asked the blind man, what do you want me to do for you? And he was specific, that I may receive my sight. Child of God, what do you want God to do for you? Concerning your spiritual life, do you want to see the true state of that preacher? Do you want God to open your eyes to see the Leviathan spirit upon that pulpit, in that altar? There's a serpent on your pulpit. If God opens your eyes, you'll be afraid of where you have been. Father, I want to be free to serve you, to follow you. Up your mother cry. I want to be free, Lord. I want to be free. To preserve my faith, O God. To preserve my faith, O God. To walk with you, Lord. To serve you, Lord. Sing a song like this and say, free at last, it is finished. Life has triumphed over death. Jesus reigns, bless the of this world, bondage of riches, bondage of serving men, but serving God alone. You are going to God and say, Father,
Father,
anything in this world,
that
if you ask me to drop,
and
it will give me sorrow, Father, deliver me now. Open your mouth and cry, that is bondage. That is bondage. Sacrifice Isaac, it was just a test. Do you think that Jesus wanted that man to be poor? He wanted to test him. If he really, really valued Jesus as a good master, by not wanting to drop up his wealth. It meant that he didn't really mean that good master greeting. He was a hypocrite. That's how they make rich men pastors in the churches. Hypocrites are pastors in the churches. Because they are there for their belly. To use the people of God as merchandise to boost their finances. You are going to cry to God. You're going to pray and say, Father, help me to pass all my tests. When you demand for something, help me, Lord, to say yes, Lord. Open your mouth and cry to God. Help me to say yes, Lord. He will not tell you it is a test. He will not tell you it is a test. He will not give you expo. But he wants to test your heart. He wants to test my heart. Whether we truly believe. Lord, when we sing in his Lord, when we are jumping and shouting, I say we love him. He wants to test us. Ah, Kalabos Shakaya. Father, help me to pass my test. Help me to pass my test. Help me not to fail any test. In the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus said, obey the commandment. I would have said, Master, I know I'm trying, but please help me. I wouldn't have gone to boast. When you give yourself 10 over 10, yes. you are lifting the bar. Yes. But when you come as nothing, when you come with 2 over 10, God will raise you. You're going to lead over 10, Father. about them? What about the daughters? What about the sons of Jesus? Mother means she has children. We are going to bless her father. Let all the children of the mother of harlots begin to manifest and be exposed from the pulpit. To the children's church. Open your mouth and pray. Wherever they are. Children of the womb, God, mother of harlots, polluting the people of God, drinking the blood of saints. Let them begin to manifest. Scatter their works. Scatter them. All their networking. Their networking. Break them, O God, in precious blood. Destroy their activities. In the name of Jesus Christ. We are going to pray for President Donald J. Trump. Jesus, I am at the center. It's my matter. It's my matter. We are going to pray for my dear
Father.
Sit on your son.
Sit on your son.
Right now, he is your Cyrus.
Right now, he is your Cyrus.
He is your Cyrus.
He is your Cyrus.
Father,
hold him by the right hand.
God preachers. They are preachers that are surrounding that man. Many of them are not of God. The Lord needs to remove some of them from that man's life. Let that man face God. Father, hold Donald Trump.
By the right hand.
Show him how to go.
Show him where to go.
Tell him who to listen to.
Tell him who to listen.
Like you told Saul.
Like you told Saul.
Now Apostle Paul.
Now Apostle Paul.
Father, let him hear you clear. The way Apostle Paul heard you. Open your mouth and pray. I'm going to pray and say, Father, every Christian in the United States of America,
every Christian in the United States of America,
under the influence of Jezebel,
under the influence of Jezebel,
to fight Donald Trump,
to fight Donald Trump,
Father,
enter their hearts,
open their eyes,
open their eyes,
deliver them from spiritual blindness. Open your mouth and pray for our brethren. In Jesus Christ, mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
People of God, we are about to round up. Before we pray the final prayers, We remind you once again that on Sunday, if Jesus tarries, 6 p.m. Nigerian time, 6 p.m. Nigerian time, all the youths will be gathered before the Lord. Akalepokosunda, for a time of revival. God wants to revive our youths. Keep on praying for the youths. Pray for them, our children. Invite the youths, wherever they are, give them data. If you can buy phone for them. Fix data for them. And let them come to this global altar. And let God Almighty do what He alone can do in the life of the youths. All over the world. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Till we see again on Sunday, Jesus tarries. God bless you. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Heaven is our home at last. We're not going to miss that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lift your hands and say, Father. Jesus Christ. From this global altar, all over the nations, no more bloodshed. Open your mouth and cry. No more bloodshed. No more. Father. No more. No more. No more bloodshed. From this altar in Nigeria, no more, no more bloodshed, no more bloodshed. Raga na boko sete ya, raga gaga na chala gaya, raba koko sete le galaje, raga gaga gaga, raba.